Hey everyone, in this video we're going to export videos from Cartoon Animator using Fit to Object Size in order to composite them into DaVinci Resolve. We're going to place these cute little cartoon dudes into a real-life forest scene for post-production. First things first, we'll need to export each of the characters in our project as their own separate video layers. In previous versions of Cartoon Animator, you were required to export each object separately one by one. But with 4.5, we now have the option to simultaneously export each object as its own video. First, we need to make sure that we choose MOV format with transparent video, since we're compositing them onto another video. Then, in the new Object Sequence section, we have the option to export into separate files, which will render a separate video file for each object in the scene. You can also choose to fit the video export size to the selection box of your character, as opposed to the regular project render output size. This saves tons of time and makes your video file sizes smaller and easier to manage. Once we export, you'll notice that it will now ask us to choose a folder name instead of a file name. This is the folder where all of the exported MOVs will render to, and each will be named according to its object name in Cartoon Animator. You'll see that because the ladybug was just a prop that wasn't animated, it will export as a single transparent PNG image, along with a separate background, which also goes for other scene elements that aren't animated. Meanwhile, our three little monster dudes will export as their own video files, each with their unique names. You can play back to see the looping animation that we exported from our project range. Okay, let's move on to our post-production in DaVinci Resolve. The first thing I want to do is click and drag my ladybug image, along with the monster video files, into the media pool. From there, we can simply import them all into the timeline and align them together so that their lengths are consistent. The next step is to change the positions of each video layer as the timeline progresses in order to simulate our characters prancing through the forest. To do so, you need to ensure that you add a position transform key at the first frame of each clip to mark the starting point, and then progress to the end of the clip and move the layer a certain distance to the left in order to simulate walking. If you wish to simulate a change in distance like I'm doing with this yellow character, you can also add a key at the beginning for the zoom size and enlarge the size of the video layer later on in the timeline. This will create the appearance of the character moving closer to the camera. Once I'm done that, then I can play back to see our initial movement through the forest. Next, let's take a look at how to add some effects. The first one we're going to search for is the blur box in order to simulate a depth of field effect. Make sure your video layer is selected, and then simply click on the effect from the effect library to apply it. Our green character is reasonably close to the main focal range of our project, so we're only going to blur him slightly. But for the background yellow guy, we can apply a stronger blur effect as he's further away, and then keyframe to a weaker strength as he moves closer to the focal range. When we play back now, you'll see a gradual weakening of the fade as he comes closer to the camera. Okay, now we can move on to the ladybug layers. For the ladybugs, after I get them into position by resizing and rotating, I'm going to use the color space transform effect in order to maintain a more consistent tone between the ladybugs and the tree trunk. Once they're in position, I can search for color space transform and apply it to both of my ladybug layers. By increasing the adaptive slider, you'll see them become darker to more closely conform with the video layer they're placed on top of. Now, you'll notice that when we play back, since our background video is panning from left to right, those poor ladybugs get left behind. This can be resolved by adding tracking. To combine them together, you can multi-select both ladybug layers, right-click and create a compound clip. Once that's done, we can open the color window, select our background video, and then click on Tracker to create a tracker. We'll then select Stabilize, Classic Stabilizer, and then Point Tracker. Once I've added a tracking reference point, then I can move it to the trunk of the tree, which is where we want the ladybugs to maintain position relative to everything else in the scene. We can play back to see that tracking point now maintains its position on the tree. Therefore, we can now copy the track data from that clip, select our ladybug compound clip, and go into the stabilizer and paste that track data. After which we also need to enter in a strength of negative 100 and hit stabilize again in order for there to be less shaking on that clip layer. If I play back now, you'll see the ladybug staying in position relative to the trunk of the closest tree. The last effect I'm going to apply is a camera shake to give us a bit more of an immersive perspective. We're going to need to select all of the clip layers for this and create another compound clip that I'll name All. We can then search for the camera shake effect and apply it to our compound clip. If we enable loop playback, it will allow us to adjust the various camera shake parameters without interruption in order to maybe simulate the viewpoint of a fellow tiny monster trekking through the forest. Once I'm satisfied with the levels, then it's time to export. I'll simply go over to Deliver, choose the name and render settings for my clip, and then add it to the render queue and render. That's how quick and easy it is to export multiple object layers simultaneously from Cartoon Animator and composite them together in DaVinci Resolve. I hope you learned a lot in this tutorial, and be sure as always to check out our forums at forum.reallusion.com. I'll see you in the next video.